Hello children, good morning. Today I am going to teach another lesson, that is unit 5, air that makes us live. In that lesson 13, air around us. What is our lesson name? Air around us. Let us see. Air is all around us. All living beings need air to live. We cannot live without air. Keep your forefinger below your nose and breathe out. You feel air coming out. We cannot see air, but we can feel it. Air contains many gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, water vapor, dust and germs. So air is all around us. Everywhere. There is no place without air. So all living beings need air. What are the living beings? Human beings, animals, plants, insects, worms. So these are living beings need air. Can we live without air? No. Every living organism need air to live. Means we breathe oxygen. Yes, no? So that oxygen is present in the air. So we breathe through our nose. We breathe in oxygen and we breathe out carbon dioxide. Yes? And keep your forefinger below your nose. You feel air. Yes? But here, we cannot see air. Can you see air? No, we cannot see. But we can feel it. So in the mornings and evenings, we get cool breeze. Yes, how do we feel? We feel very happy. Can you see that air? No, we cannot see. We can feel it. And air contains many gases. What are that? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, water vapor. These gases are present in the air and also dust and germs. Dust and germs are also present in the air. Next, air has water vapor. When we wash our clothes, they get wet. When we put them out in the sun, they become dry. So we wear clothes, they become dirty. So we wash that dirty clothes, then they become wet. So we put that wet clothes in the hot sun, then they become dry. Yes? Where has the water from your clothes gone? Where has the water from your clothes gone? The water from our wet clothes has gone into the air. So we put the wet clothes in the sun. Yes, and they become dry. So water is present in the wet clothes. Yes, and where it has gone? It is mixed with the air. It has gone into the air. The water from our wet clothes has gone into the air. The heat of the sun changes the water from wet clothes into very tiny drops of water called a water vapor. The change of water into water vapor is called a evaporation. So we put the wet clothes in the sun. So due to the sun's heat, the water in the wet clothes changes into water vapor. Changes into water vapor. So this water vapor is lighter than the water. Yes? So it rises up. This water vapor is lighter than the air. So this rises up. It mixes with the air. Okay children. So what is evaporation? The change of water into water vapor is called evaporation. The change of water into water vapor is called evaporation. So let us see this activity. So let us see how water changes into water vapor. Take an empty kettle, fill it with water, keep the kettle on the stove and heat it. After some time, water boils. When water gets heated, hot gas comes out of the kettle. It is called steam. Steam is the gas that comes out of boiling water. So take one kettle, fill it with water and keep on the flame. So due to the heat, the water starts boiling. is when water is boiling, hot gas comes out of this kettle. Okay, that gas is called as steam. So the steam is also called as a water vapor. Okay, so what is a steam? Steam is the gas that comes out of boiling water. So we can observe this in our houses when our mother preparing or boiling rice or boiling water. Excellent. Next, air always contains some water vapor. We cannot see water vapor in the air, but on a rainy day, the air is full of water vapor. It takes longer time for the air to take water from wet clothes. Wet clothes take a longer time to dry up in a rainy season. So here, air always contains some water vapor. Can you see water vapor? No, we cannot see the water vapor. It is a gas. Yes, children, it is a gaseous form of water. So, but on a rainy day, more amount of water vapor is present in the air. So, it takes the longer time for the air to take water from wet clothes. So, air takes the water from the wet clothes. Yes, children, but more amount of water vapor is present in the air. So, it takes longer time to take water from the wet clothes. So, on a rainy day, so wet clothes take a longer time to dry up. Excellent. On a we put the wet clothes in the sun in a rainy season. Yes. So they take the clothes become dry after so many hours. Yes, Nana. So they take so much time to get or to become dry. Next, in summer there will be a little water vapor in the air. Clothes dry quickly in summer as the dry air takes water vapor very quickly. So in summer season, very little water vapor is present in the air. So clothes dry very quickly in the summer season. Why? The air is dry. So the dry air takes water. With the dry air takes water vapor very quickly. Means in the summer season, the sun is very hot. Yes? So, due to the heat of the sun, the clothes, the wet clothes become dry very quickly in the summer season. Okay, next. In summer, the surface water in ponds, lakes and canals changes into water vapor by the heat of the sun and goes into the air. In summer, the surface water in ponds, lakes and canals changes into water vapor by the heat of the sun and goes into the air. So in the summer season, so the sun is very hot, isn't it? So we get more heat from the sun. So, due to the heat of the sun, the surface water in a ponds, lakes, rivers and canals changes into water vapor and that goes into the air. That rises up into the air. Okay. Next, condensation. Take two dry glass tumblers, pour water in one tumbler. Put some ice cubes in another tumbler. Wash the tumblers after a few minutes. The outside of the glass with ice cubes becomes wet with drops of water. There is water vapor in the air around the tumblers. The water vapor in the air changes into water when it touches the cold glass. This change of water vapor into water is called condensation. So take two glasses, okay? So take normal water in one glass and take ice cubes in another glass. So after some time you observe these two glasses. Okay, so here what we can observe here in this glass. So here ice cubes are there in the glass. Yes, after some time we can observe the water droplets on the outer surface of the glass. Why? Here the glass become, the walls of the glass become cool. Yes, so due to the ice cubes the water vapor is present around the glass. So when this water vapor touches this cold surface, it changes into water. Did you understand, children? When the water vapor touches the surface of the ice cubes glass, okay, surface of the or walls of the glass changes into water. That is called as a condensation. Okay, so the water vapor in the air changes into water when it touches the cold glass. So this change of water vapor into water is called a condensation. Did you understand, children, what is condensation? So the change of water into water the change of water vapor into water is called a condensation. Okay, next. Air as dust. Air contains dust particles in it. When we sweep our homes or roads, dust rises into the air. When the wind blows, dust particles get mixed with the air. Dust particles carry disease causing germs. So air has dust. So air contains dust particles. How the dust particles enters into the air? So we sweep the houses and roads. So when we sweep our houses and roads, the dust rises into the air. Means that mixes with the air. So when the wind blows, the dust particles are very light in weight. Yes, Nana? So along with the wind, the dust particles also blow and mixed with the air. So these dust particles carry disease causing germs. What are the disease causing germs? Bacteria, virus, fungi. Yes, so these bacteria, virus are present. So microorganisms are present in the dust particles. Yes, children. So these dust particles carry disease causing germs. Next, air as smoke. Air as smoke. Smoke enters into the air from the chimneys of factories, houses, motor vehicles, etc. Cars and buses give out smoke. This black smoke mixes with the air. This smoke makes the air impure. There is smoke in the air around us. So air is smoke. Smoke, do you know smoke? Yes, this is smoke. Yes, student. So smoke enters in the air from the chimneys of factories. Are you seeing? Are you observing this? Yes. So these are the chimneys. So the smoke enters into the air from the chimneys of the factories and houses and from motor vehicles. Yes, so many vehicles. Yes, Nana. Cars, buses, lorries, this bikes. Yes, so many vehicles that are releasing smoke into the air. So this black smoke mixes with the air. So this smoke makes the air impure. Okay, and this smoke, there is a smoke in the air around us. So this smoke mixes with the air and it spreads to every place. It spreads to all around us. Yes, children. Egg has germs. Egg has germs also. If we sneeze or cough, germs enter into air. Germs causes illness. Dust, smoke and germs make the air impure. Such air is called polluted air. If we breathe polluted air, we become ill. We must keep a handkerchief near our mouth when we sneeze or cough. We must always breathe fresh and clean air. So air has germs also. Yes, so when we sneeze, that time germs means we release some germs from our mouth. So that enters into the air. So these germs, if we breathe that air which has germs, we become ill. So dust, smoke, germs make the air impure. So that impure air is called a polluted air. Polluted air. Okay, if we breathe polluted air, we become ill. We become ill means we get diseases. So when we are sneezing or cough, when we get cough, that time we should cover our mouth with a handkerchief. Okay children, and we must always breathe fresh and clean air. Fresh and clean air. So nowadays the air is impure, isn't it? So many dust particles are there, germs are there, smoke is there. So if we breathe that, we become ill or we get diseases. Okay children, so we must grow plants and trees around our house. Plants make the air pure. We should always play in open grounds. Windows of the houses should be kept open to allow fresh air into the house. When we sleep, we should not cover our face with a blanket. So air has a impurities. Yes, Nana? Air is a impure. So we should make the air pure, or free from germs, dust, smoke. So how can we make the air pure? So by growing plants and trees around our house, we can make the air pure. Means the dust, germs and smoke, these are all removed from the air by growing the plants and trees. Means they take the impurities from the air and they make the air clean and fresh. And we should always play in a open grounds, in a playgrounds. And windows of the houses should be kept open to allow fresh air into the house. So windows, doors of the houses, they must be opened always. Why? They allow the fresh air inside the house and release as carbon dioxide. So that goes out through the ventilators or windows. Okay children. And when we sleep, we should not cover our face with a blanket. So while sleeping, we should not cover our face with the blankets. Okay, why? So we release carbon dioxide, we take oxygen. So if we cover our face with the blanket, the carbon dioxide which we are releasing out, that is present inside the blanket only. Yes, so again we breathe that. Again we are breathing that only. So we should not cover our face while sleeping. Okay, did you understand children? So this is our lesson. So what are the gases present in the air? Oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, water vapor and dust, germs, smoke. These are also present. And what is evaporation? The change of water into water vapor is called evaporation. And what is condensation? The change of water vapor into water is called condensation. Did you understand, children, this? Okay, good. So, listen carefully, understand the lesson and read it. Okay, children.